Hello everybody, and welcome to this lecture on computer architecture. Today we take another look at finite state machines. Remember, in the last lecture we made a finite state machine that had no input but only output and memory. And that is a so-called MOR machine, or a sequencer. Today we take another example of a MOR machine, but a little bit more complicated, because we take a more complicated flip-flop as our basis, namely the set-reset flip-flop. In the last lecture we took a toggle flip-flop, which actually is much easier to use. So now we complicate the things a little bit, so that it will be more informative for you. So let's take a look. We're going to build a 2-bit counter, so it has no input, but only output and memory. And we're going to do this with this set-reset flip-flop. To go back, what was a set-reset flip-flop? Well, this is this one, as you remember. It's a very simple thing. It has two NOR gates, and it has feedback. So the output of one NOR gate goes to the input to the other NOR gate. And then you get, which is important, you get this truth table, meaning that if it's 0-0, the output is maintained. Q stays whatever it was, and not Q will be the opposite of whatever the Q is. And if you do S0 and R1, then you reset the flip-flop. So that means the output is 0. And if you do on the contrary, you do set equals to 1 and reset equals to 0, you get then the output is set to 1. And the 1-1 combination is not allowed, because that will put it in a non-desired state, uncontrollable state. This we can forget. What is actually now, what is more important for this kind machines that we have, is the action or excitation table, meaning that if we want to achieve a certain action, what do we have to do? Now I've made it here, I have put it here in a table for all kinds of flip-flops that we're using in these lectures, but these two, the JK and the T and D, we can forget for this lecture. So what we have to focus on is the set-reset flip-flop. So that means that if we want to change the state at the output from 0 to 0, meaning we want to keep it, we can do this in, let's look here in the table. If the state is 0, we can either maintain it, meaning we put 0-0 at the input, or we can actually reset the output, force it to be 0. So there are two options, 0-0 or 0-1, and we abbreviate this with set equal to 0, and reset is then don't care, can be 0 or 1. And if we want to change the state from 0 to 1, then we have to do this. We can see this in this table. We have to actually give a set at the input. The only way to put a 1 if the state at the output was 0 is to put a set equals to 1. So that means 1 at the input, and the other than the reset must be 0, because 1-1 is not allowed. And so forth. It is also going from 1 to 0. How do we do this? Well, we must give a set equal to 0 and a reset equal to 1. And if we want to keep the state from 1 to 1, we can either keep it by 0-0, or we can actually force it to be 1 by set equals to 1 and equals to 0. So that means set is don't care, and reset is equals to 0. So this is our excitation table. Here we have the truth table. Here above we had the truth table. And now we have also the excitation table that we're going to use. If we want to achieve this, then we have to do this. Okay, so this one we can for the moment, and we're going now to build a 2-bit counter based on set reset flip-flops. So I put it here already, prepared it. This is our task, a 2-bit counter with set reset flip-flops. Here's the action table or excitation table, whatever you want to call it, and we will have two flip-flops, which I will draw here. They have set. So this one I will take as the first one, reset 0, and it has here Q0 and not Q0. I think I want a little bit smaller, thinner pen. And here the other one. No, I want it further apart. I want it here. Here's the second flip-flop. Set 1, output 1, reset 1, and not output 1, not 0, but not output 1. So we have here two of those flip-flops, 2 bits, because remember, we want a 2-bit counter, So it has four different states possible, and four different states, it means we need two bits to store these four states. So we take this two set reset flip-flops. So now we have to make a table about the actual state and what will be the next state. So that means that Q1, Q0, imagine the state is 0, 0. Of course, we want that the next state is 0, 1, because it's a counter. So we call this the actual state, and this is the next state. Put a line here, if I can draw it a little bit linear. Linear lines, I like this. What if the state is 0, 1? Well, then we want our next state to be digital binary 2, that is 1, 0. And if the state is 1, 0, we want it to be binary 3, that is 1, 1. And if it is binary 3, we want to go back to counting original. We want to go back to 0. So then I can show here, what do we have to do? In this case, I want Q1, I want it to go from 0 to stay at 0, meaning the mouse doesn't move, from 0 to 0. So we know how to do this, actually. How do we have to do this? I look in the table. If I want to go from 0 to 0, I look here at the table. From 0 to 0, I have to put the set equal to 0, and the reset is don't care. Now for Q0, we can also make, for the other flip-flop, we can also make such an analysis. We want this Q0 go from 0 to 1, from 0 to 1. And I will look in the table how to do this. From 0 to 1, I have a set equals to 1 and a reset equals to 0. 1, 0. So now let's do the same here. 0 goes to 1. I know how to do this. Set has to be 1, reset has to be 0, and this one goes from 1 to 0. I know from 1 to 0 how to do this. I have to get the set equal to 0 and a reset equal to 1. This one from 1 to 1. So from 1 to 1. How to do this? Let me look at the table. It is set is don't care and reset is 0. And the Q0 flip-flop goes from 0 to 1, from 0 to 1. Let me look how to do this. From 0 to 1, I have to give 1 set and 0 reset. Let me wait till the mouse moves. 1 set, 0 reset. When the state is 1, 1, I want it to be 0, 0, so I have to reset both flip-flops. This goes from 1 to 0, and that is done by, from 1 to 0 is done, let me look here, from 1 to 0 is done by 0, 1, and this one also goes from 1 to 0, so we have to give 0, 1 at the input. Okay, so now we have four functions, four logic functions. These are two logic functions here, and there are two logic functions here that are a function of these two inputs. And we have to design a logic array to implement these functions. So we have four functions, meaning four truth tables. Those are here, these are the truth tables, two input values and four output values. So we have four of them, and we can make four Carnot maps, and then we make four circuits. So let's do first this red one. I want to say that this is the red one. Okay, I will first do S1. S1, how do I do this? S1, Carnot map, two input variables. It is Q1 and not Q1, Q0 and not Q0, and we fill it up. Well, I'll do this a little bit faster because time, so I can do this fast. This 0 appears here, this 1 appears here, if I'm not mistaken. In case of forgetting, you can always write down here the min terms. So this was Q1 and not Q0. This is Q not Q1 and Q0. This is Q1 and not Q0. This is Q1 and Q0. So that little bit doubt here, where does this one disappear? And this one goes at not Q1, Q0, not Q1, Q0. So that was this one. Now, this X, I already know, it goes here. And this 0, it goes here. So we have this Carnot map, and now we can decide this X, do we want it to be 0 or 1? Well, if this is a 1, then we have an XOR gate, which is 16 transistors. But I prefer an AND gate, so I take here, I choose to be 0, and then we have only this term, which is Q0 and not Q1. So let me draw this in here, Q0 and not Q1 goes to be to the set. So I put here an AND gate, and not Q1, that is this one. It goes in here, and it is ended with Q0, and that goes into S1. Nice. Okay, let's take the green one. Reset 1. I've put it in green. I do the same. So bear with me. There we go again. Q1, not Q1, Q0, not Q0, not Q0, this X, we already know, it goes here, this 0, it goes here, this 0, it goes here, and this 1 goes here. Once again, we can decide to make this 0 or a 1. I like for the same reason, I like to put here 0, and then this only term that we have here is R1 equals, we have to put here S1 equals, R1 equals Q1 and Q0. Q1 and Q0. So the reset of flip-flop 1 is an AND gate with here the output goes like this, and this one is ended with this, and this goes to a little bit poor drawing, but you get the idea. It's not, this is here, it's not connected, of course. Now let me go to blue and let's do the other one. We have here this 0, which is the input at this place here. How to make this? Well, we make another Carnot map. It's getting maybe a little bit boring, but you get the idea by now. Q1, not Q1, Q0, not Q0. This one appears here, this 0 appears here, this one appears here, and this here. Okay, we join these two ones. So remember, that is what the Carnot map is for. And we have, this is actually, we have to say what this is S0, and S0 equals not Q0. That's nice. So S0 is not Q0, so that goes here. That's simple. It's not even a logic circuit, it's just a line. And finally, let's see if I can find a color, maybe brown. I will design this one, R0, and R0 will have the following Carnot map. Oh, I should do this a little bit nicer. Q1, Q0, not Q0. Where are we? This 0 appears here, this 1 appears here, this 0 appears here, and this 1, final this 1, appears here. We have these two which we join in the Carnot map. This is nice, they're neighbors, so we can eliminate a variable. Which variable? Well, that is Q1, so R0 equals Q0. That is nice. Actually, R0 goes here, and then it doesn't connect here. We have the input like this. So this is then our final circuit. We have a set reset 2-bit counter that counts 00, 01, 10, 11, 00, 01, etc. And the output then, of course, is here, is the least significant bit, and the other output is here, which is the most significant bit. A 2-bit counter based on the set reset flip-flops using our techniques of making a truth table, then making an action table, which you see here, or actually you can also call it an excitation table. This is the action. I would call this the action table. This is what we have to do. And this is the excitation table, meaning how to do this. And these excitations are logic functions of the actual state which we have here on the left. And then just following, it's just a logic array, just logic as we have done, Boolean array. And with this Boolean array, we make a truth table, that is this. And then we implement this logic by designing Carnot maps, which you see here on the bottom. And with the Carnot maps, we can then make the circuit. Okay, so this is another example of a Moore machine, a sequencer, which is a subset of actually of finite state machines. I hope you enjoyed this lecture. See you in the next one.